Hello, my friend, Pastor Curt here, and I've got a question for you as usual. And here's a question. What are you going to do today? You know, we're all going a little bit stir crazy right now. We have been locked down and shut in and sequestered and safety mode and coronavirus, shut down, social distancing, stay in your home, don't go out, wear a mask, wear a mask, wear a mask. And well, if you're like me, you're starting to get a little antsy. You know, whether you live all by yourself, that's a particular type of challenge, or whether you're like me and you got five other adults in your house, you need to know what your plan is. Let me give you a little hint. The plan might be different than you think it is. The plan might be about you practicing real religion. What do I mean by real religion? What I mean is simply this. You and I, in these moments of testing, in these moments of going stir crazy, are going to determine whether or not our faith is a part of our resume or a part of our soul. Whether our faith is something that we have as a parachute or a safety net on our life, or it's our very identity. James talks about this very deliberately, and he's super clear. He says this in James 1, verse 27. Religion that God our Father accepts as pure and faultless is this, to look after orphans and widows in their distress and to keep oneself from being polluted by the world. In other words, what you should do with today is love on someone else. Even someone in your home, your family that's driving you nuts right now. We're calling a lot of people at Bayside. We made 30,000 calls the last 2 weeks just to check in on people and say, can I pray for you? Can I love you? We're sending meals to people. By the way, you got a phone too. What if you made today about loving someone else, about lessening your worries and anxieties about you, your future, your business, your kids, and you reached out and loved someone? What if, well, you got into the mask making business? My wife's making these masks. They're not like surgical masks. This is mine, superheroes, but they've made about 3,000 of them. Guess what? At first, when we were making them, people were like, we don't want those masks. Does anyone want those masks? Now the phone is ringing off the hook. First responders, ambulance drivers. People want to make sure that they're not taking the good masks away from the doctors and nurses. And so they're doing their part by wearing these masks. I guarantee you, the people making these masks, and there's about 500 of them now in just the Facebook group my wife's in, the people that are making these masks are happier than the people that are worried about themselves. I know it's hard not to worry, and you should worry a little bit. It's reasonable, it's responsible, but get to helping the widows and the orphans. Get to doing something that unleashes compassion. By the way, a ton of you have been doing this around Bayside, and I just want to tell you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Keep it up, house by house, apartment by apartment. Let's unleash some compassion today.